Here is your God, Israel. They have cried, sinners competes with him. So he spoke this parable to them. What man among you with a 100 sheep, losing one, would not leave the 99 in the wilderness and go after the missing one till he found it? And when he found it, would not joyfully take it on his shoulders, and then when he got home, all together his friends and neighbors, rejoice with me, he would say, I found my sheep that was lost. In the same way, I tell you, there will be more rejoicing in heaven for one of repentant sinner than over 99 virtuous men who have no need of repentance. Or again, what woman with 10 drachmas would not, if she lost one, light a lamp and sweep out the house and search truly till she found it? And then, when she had found it altogether, her friends and neighbors, rejoice with me, she would say, I found the drachma I lost. In the same way, I tell you, there is rejoicing among the angels of God over one repentant sinner. He also said, a man had two sons. The younger said to his father, Father, let me have the share of the estate that should come to me. So the father divided the property between them. A few days later, the younger son got together everything he had and left for a distant country where he spent his money on a life of debauchery. When he had spent it all, that country experienced a severe famine, and now he began to feel the pinch. So he hired himself out to one of the local inhabitants to put him on his farm to feed the pigs. And he would willingly have filled his belly with the husks the pigs were eating, but no one offered him anything. Then he came to his senses and said, how many of my father's paid servants have more food than they want? And here I am dying of hunger. I will leave this place and go to my father and say, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son. Treat me as one of your paid servants. So he left the place and went back to his father. While he was still a long way off, his father saw him and was moved with pity. He ran to the boy, clasped him in his arms, and kissed him tenderly. Then his son said, Father, I have sinned against heaven and against you. I no longer deserve to be called your son. But the father said to his servants, quick, bring out the best robe and put on him. Put a ring on his finger and sandals on his feet. Bring the calf we have been fattening, and kill it. We are going to have a feast, a celebration, because this son of mine was dead and was come back to life. He was lost and is found. Then they began to celebrate. Now the other son was out in the fields, and on his way back, as he drew near the house, he could hear music and dancing. Calling one of the servants, he asked what it was all about. Your brother has come, replied the servant, and your father has killed the calf he had of Abner, because he has got him back safe and sound. He was angry then and refused to go in, and his father came out to plead with him. But he answered his father, look, all these years I have slaved for you and never once disobeyed your orders, yet you never offered me so much as a gift for me to celebrate with my friends. But for this your son of yours, when he comes back after stolen your property, he and his woman, you kill the calf he had been fattening. The father said, my son, you are with me always, and all I have is yours. determined to see, because that golden coins of the parable are the simple coins. They were used as a crown in the marriage of a woman on the second temple period. So Jesus is telling that as that coins are important to a woman when she is preparing herself for the marriage, in the same way God, it is happy when we enter in alliance with Him. To us Christians, that alliance is the baptism. The third parable, it is known as the parable of the prodigal son. Yet Jesus, more than to show us the prodigality of the son, wants to show us the mercy of the Father. But who are these two sons? When Jesus told 2,000 years ago, was to explain the importance of his mission, calling the house of Ephraim, also known as the 10 lost tribes of Israel that was on all the world, and reunite them with the house of Judah. The house of Ephraim, it is symbolized on the younger son, on the younger brother, the elder son, it is the house of Judah. But to the father, both are important, and both are sons. So, dear brethren, the main question for us today is, how do we receive in our communities those young brothers that, by conversion, return to our Heavenly Father's house? Did we have the same attitude of the elder brother of the parable, or we have the same merciful heart of the Father, remembering what we ask in the Lord's Prayer, saying, "Forgive our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us." So, if we really want to receive mercy from the Heavenly Father, we have to show mercy to those who approach to salvation through the Church, whose head it is the Lord Jesus. May the Lord Jesus Christ protect our homes, families, and friends.
Amen.
Let us proclaim our faith. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, all things visible and invisible. I believe in the Lord Jesus Christ, the only God, the Son of God, born from the Father of all ages, God the Father, life of life, true God and true God, begotten and not made, from the Son of God, who forgive us sins of today, for us men are our salvation. By the Holy Spirit, as the instrument of the Church of Heaven, he came at. For our Savior's crucified and conscious Christ, he set our death in the prayer, and rose again on the third day in the promises of the Church. He is ascended to heaven, and is the right hand of the Father. He will come again, Lord, to shed his name in heaven, and his kingdom will come from heaven. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord and the Lord of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son, who is the Father and the Son, who is the Lord and Lord of life, who has brought us to the promise. I believe in one who is the heavens and all the church. I confess the baptism of the forgiveness of sins, and I will hope for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Et de dire
comfort to the honor of your name may serve the salvation of all. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal Father. For you lay the foundations of the world, and have arranged a changing of times and seasons. You form man in your own image, and set humanity over the whole world in all its wonder, to rule in your name over all you have made, and forever praise you in your mighty works through Christ our Lord. And so with all the angels we praise you, as in joyful celebration we acclaim singing.
Sanctus,
Sanctus,
Sanctus Dominus Deus Sabaoth, plenissimum celi et terra, gloria tua.
Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for men, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me. The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, and confess your resurrection, and give you God's image. As we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church, spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Lord, and Manuel, our bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in mercy. Welcome them into the light of the place. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased throughout the ages, we may merit to be convinced with eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Amen.
At the same time, and formatted by teaching, we are there to say, Our Father, Which is
Peace I give, my peace I give.
Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you all.
Anos Dei, qui talis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Anos Dei, qui talis peccata mundi, miserere nobis. Anos Dico vobis gaudium est angelis Dei super uno peccatore penitenti. Beatus cui remissa est iniquitas, et obtectum est peccatum. Beatus vir cui non imputavit Dominus delictum, nec est in spiritu eius dolus. Quoniam tacui in vetero verunt ossa mea, dum fugirem tota die. Quoniam die ac nocte gravata et super me manus tua, in ardoribus estatis. Peccatum meum cognitum tibi fessi, et delictum meum non abscondi. Tu es refugium meum, tribulatione conservabis me, exultationibus salutis circundabis me. Intellectum tibi davo, et instruam te in via qua gradieri, firmavo super te oculos meos. Multi dolores impi, sperantem autem in Domino, misericordia circundavi. Let amin in domino et exultate justi, et gloria mini omnes recti corde. Gloria Patri et Filio et et in saecula saeculorum, amen. Tantum ergo sacramentum veneremur celui, et antiquum documentum novos prestet fides supplementum sensum defectui. Genitori genitoque laus et jubilatio salus honor virtus quoque sit et benedictio procedenti ab utroque hom parsis laudatio.
Take possession of our minds and bodies, so that its effects, and not our own desires, may always prevail in us. Through Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
So, don't forget what we heard in the Gospel today, my dear brethren. And remember the importance of mercy to the salvation of the world. If we are merciful to one another, we shall receive the mercy of God in our own lives. If we are not merciful, so may God help us. I want to wish you a good weekend to all, and to those who are in vacations, good vacations. The Lord be with you. May Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. The Mass is ended.
Salve Regina, Mater Misericordiae, vita dulcedo, espes nostra salve. A te clamamus, exules filii Evae, a te suspiramus, gementes et flentes, in hac lacrimarum.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Não, 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 não Hát minden a sólít, jó fel, minden a sólít, szépás feladulít, minden a sólít.
Na, hogy mi is figyelme, de figyelme van.
Ha én is mit látszom. Ha én, nem tanítsam.
Na,
nem tudom, hogy mit tanítsam.
Köszönjük, hogy mit tanítsam. Fogtam a szóval, és fogtad egy ilyen szóval. Hogy a fagyomban fogtad, hogy mi is fogtunk a lány, nekem a lány a fas.
Thank you. Jesus,
Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, Jesus, J